Hello guys, I'm here still at the Home and Garden Show, and I'm here with Russell, and Russell is going to talk to us about solar. Hi Russell, how are you?
Doing great, thank you. Welcome to the show. My name is Russell Barnett with Sun Solar. This is our company. We're happy to be here. The reason why solar is so popular is because of the ever-increasing cost of electricity, and it can just continues to rise. And so with our program, you're able to get solar for zero out-of-pocket, zero upfront costs, 1.49 financing, and it comes with a 26% tax credit, which essentially means the government is...
This is important. Like I was going to talk to you about the tax credit.
Yes.
So the government will pay 26%?
Yes.
Up to what?
So the government pays 26% of the entire cost of your solar system, and also any other construction or re-roofing that you do at the same time. Also, the government will pay for 26% of that as well. So a lot of our customers...
There's limit to that or just open?
Any construction that's related to the structure of the home or the roof and done at the same time as they're getting solar can be part of the financing at the 1.49%. So a lot of our customers were just about to do a new roof. So now they don't have to come out of pocket $20,000 or $30,000 because they just rolled that into their financing at 1.49%, and they're able to get that same 26% government subsidy on the overall cost of their entire solar system, including their construction. So you have the zero out of pocket, 1.49% financing, the 26% tax credit. It comes with a 25-year warranty, and that's for everything, whether that's the service or one panel needs to be replaced, all of it. It comes with all of it. And the single best thing that they just added to our program, which sets us apart from all other solar companies, is that we are now integrated with Vivint. So Vivint Home Automation and Home Security is the number one home automation company in the nation, and the number two home security company in the nation. And when you open the Vivint app now, you're going to be able to see not only your doorbell camera, your doorbell view or any other yard cameras, not only your Nest thermostat, but also all of your percentage of large appliance usage in your home. So how much of a usage what your AC unit used, how much your heater used, and your other large appliances, washer, dryer, etc. So there's a lot of transparency in that app now, and it's all integrated into one app. No other product on the market has that. So it's a real differentiator, and there was no price increase to do that integration. So we're really excited about it.
Russell, let me ask a question a lot of people, they ask, like, does the orientation of the house makes different when you install a solar?
It does. It doesn't mean that if somebody's orientation, if anybody's been asked, if anybody's looked into solar, they've been asked before, do you have southern facing part of your roof, or is any of your roof or a large part of your roof southern facing? That is advantageous because as the sun rises in the east and sets in the west, it beats on the southern southern face of the roof all day. So that is your hottest point. So it makes the solar panels the most efficient, and they create the most high energy intake, and therefore the cost of the overall solar system is reduced because less panels are necessary. The more southern facing roof line, the less panels are necessary for the home. But we tell everybody, it doesn't matter if you don't even have one roof line southern facing, it doesn't mean you can't get solar. It just means you're gonna likely have one or two more solar panels in another spot to account for it, that's all.
Does it have to be on the top of the roof, or it could be like on the backyard? Because some people, they think it looks ugly when they have like this panels all over the roof, it cover the roof.
They primarily are mounted on the roof. However, it is also common for them to be mounted on patio awnings and patio coverings. The solar panels are extremely light, and so it's not a problem at all to do that. And then we have some people that build a structure because they want to use the solar panels as a carport per se. So you can build a structure on the side of their house where they're, you know, say their garage is a detached garage, so we'll help somebody build a structure on the side of their house and then put the panels on top of that, or they can put them on their detached garage. We have other people that have a hillside that is part of their land, and they just mount them that way. We have ground mounts of a structure system that are built that way, and they're secured into the ground, and they're able to put all their solar there. And some people put all of their solar on a slope hill right next to or in front of their home or off to the side, and they don't have anything on the roof.
But when you have like a ground mount solar panels, I'm sure like you have to have a certain distance away from any other building.
That is true. But you would have to do that anyway. Whether any structure or any construction or build that you do is going to have to be to code within, you know, 4-6 feet of a property line. And then if you're going up with a structure, you know, depending on the city. So the city of Orange, for example, you know, the back property line, you can't build any structure that's above 8 or 10 feet. You can't do that within 14 feet of the property line. So, but in the case of solar, it doesn't really apply because a ground mount is low. So in most cases, you can build that right up to your property line or within 4 feet of it.
So from what I heard from you, that if people install solar at their house, so probably the monthly payment, it might be equal or a little bit more than what they're paying right now for electricity.
No, actually, it's exactly the opposite. Typically, because the financing is at 1.49%, and just with the way that the cost structure works, the monthly payment ends up being approximately 20% of what they're paying today for electricity on their electric bill.
Oh, really?
Yes.
So they will. That's including the material, installation, construction, everything, finance, they will be paying less than what they're paying for electricity.
Not a little bit less. They'll be paying 80% less. Our goal for our customers, when we survey a home, and we can do that remotely, we get a customer's address at a show here like this, and we take down their contact information. We do... through our agreement with Google Earth and also with there's another logistics company as well, we're able to remotely put together their quote with just that address, and on average it ends up to be about all of that, everything you just named included, the cost of the system is about 20% or so, give or take, and we've zeroed out their electric bill entirely.
Wow.
And they just have that finance payment in there, but they're going to eventually own that in 15
exactly,
or 20 years.
Yeah.
So
honestly, I didn't know that, because I thought probably will be the upfront cost will be more, but a lot of people, they're not aware of that. So I'm glad that I'm putting this video out for people to know that actually, so
yeah.
At least I don't want to say okay, go ahead, but at least they can start the investigation, and here you go, they can go to you, Russell.
Absolutely. And it used to be years ago that you did have to put 20% down, and they put a lien on the home,
yeah,
to protect their
investment.
That's
what I remember.
All that's gone now. You can get it for, you do the deal for zero down. We are able to do these deals for customers with zero down, and there's no lien on the home anymore. It's a very minimal credit score required. Anybody that owns a home automatically qualifies 95% of the time. And so, you know, those are hurdles that are no longer there anymore. And with the rising cost of electricity, especially Southern California Edison here in Southern California where we are, but really everywhere, with the rising cost of electricity, this is a way where your finance payment for the cost of your solar system, that is one payment. That payment's gonna stay the same for your 15 or 20 years.
Yeah.
It's never changing. Whereas if you don't have solar, your electricity costs are going up every year, and they're gonna continue to go up every year. So this is a way for you to lock in that 20% payment, and you eventually own your system, and then you really are zero, what we're about to call, what's gonna be an industry term here, which is you really are a net zero home.
And also the cost of the electricity is going to keep going up because of the global warming, and we don't have winter anymore.
Yeah, that's
so
the truth.
So people, they use air conditioning all year around.
Right.
So the cost of electricity, besides the increase of the cost of the electricity, but the usage will be a lot more also because of the heat.
Right.
Like you see here, like for the last like 3-4 years, how many days did we get actually cold that we don't need air conditioning?
Right. That's a good point. And it's just going to continue in that direction, as is with the cost of electricity. It's never going down, it's only going up, but at least this way the finance payment on the system is always going to be stable, it's always going to be the same, you eventually will own it, and if anything ever happens to any one of those panels or a section of panels in the system, the solar system on every home that we install is remotely monitored, and they generally will give you a call within 24 hours of a panel going out, and they schedule a tech and dispatch a tech to replace that panel or repair the panel. So that's 25 years, parts and labor.
You know, Russell, I really appreciate the time. I know I have a lot more questions, and one of the questions, actually, maybe when we meet for like a full video, we can talk about sharing, because there is a way to share the electricity and homeowner, they can get money back. So we can talk about all kind of other programs that California offer, and I really appreciate the time, and I hope that you have the best home show, and thank you so much for your time.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
I hope you have a great home show too. This is great.
Thanks
a
lot.
Thank you.